In this class, we are going to discuss about input buffering. Input buffering. The main task of lexical analyzer is it reads a source program character by character and produces a stream of tokens. Here, in order to read the tokens, the lexical analyzer mainly uses two pointers. The first pointer is lexeme begin pointer. Lexeme begin pointer. And the second pointer is forward pointer. So we know that lexical analyzer produces a stream of tokens. So in order to read each token, two pointers are used. The first pointer is lexeme begin pointer and the second pointer is forward pointer. We know what is the use of a pointer. A pointer points to a variable. That means pointer stores address of a variable. So whenever a program is saved, then the program is stored in the hard disk. During compilation also, the program resides in hard disk. But at the time of execution, the program is placed in main memory. Why? Because a program is executed by CPU. CPU can execute a program only when the program is available in main memory. So here the point is, during compilation, the program resides in hard disk. Let here our program contains a statement called int main. So the state int main, left parenthesis, right parenthesis, left curly brace, right curly brace. Let it is our program. So let's see how this program is stored in the hard disk. So what is the first character in the program? I. So first I will be stored in the hard disk. Next N will be stored. Next T will be stored. And after that we have blank space. So this is nothing but that blank space. Next we have main. So M character will be stored. Next A. Next I. Next N. So next character. Left parenthesis. Next character. Right parenthesis. So next character, left curly brace, next is some body, so some spaces, this is some space, next right curly brace. So this is nothing but our program, our input string. So our input string is stored in the computer, is stored in the hard disk in this manner. So here, in order to read the tokens, we have two pointers. The first pointer is lexeme begin pointer and the second pointer is forward pointer. So let's see what is lexeme begin pointer. The name itself specifies the meaning. Lexeme begin pointer points to the beginning character of the current lexeme. Lexeme begin pointer points to the beginning character of the current lexeme. So here this is our input string. So in this input string we have several tokens. The first token is int, next token is some main left parenthesis, right parenthesis, next token is some left curly brace, next token is right curly brace, like that. So initially, lexeme begin pointer is points to the beginning character of the current lexeme. So what is the current lexeme? Int. So lexeme begin pointer points to the beginning character of the current lexeme. So beginning character is I and what is the current lexeme? Int is the current lexeme. And let's see what is forward pointer. So initially forward pointer is placed at the beginning character of the lexeme. First forward pointer reads the first character. So what is the first character here? I. So forward pointer reads I. Next forward pointer is placed at the next memory location. So now forward pointer reads N,
Next forward pointer reads T. So that means the use of forward pointer is it reads a character and moves ahead and moves right in order to read the next character. So initially forward is it the first character, that is nothing but I. So it reads I character, next it reads N character, next it reads T character. Next forward pointer is placed at the next location. What is the next location? Blank space. So whenever forward pointer reads this blank space, then it identifies that it is the end of the lexeme. So before this blank space we have int. So this int is considered as a token, and after that the forward pointer ignores this blank space and places the lexeme begin as well as forward pointer yet the next character location. So after blank space, what is the next character? M is the next character. So forward pointer is placed at M location as well as lexeme begin pointer is also placed at next location, that is nothing but what is the next location character here? M. So then after that lexeme begin always points to the beginning character of the current lexeme. So lexeme begin pointer is places at main location. Then after that forward pointer reads M, next it reads A, next it reads I, next it reads M, next it reads left parenthesis, next it reads right parenthesis. So it will be considered as a token. Next, if you want, after the main function we can use one space here, one space, next left curly brace, next this is nothing but some body, next to some right curly brace. So whenever this forward pointer reads this blank space, then it identifies that it is the end of the lexeme. So main left parenthesis and right parenthesis is considered as a token, and it places the forward pointer and lexeme begin at the next location. So what is the next location? Left curly brace. So what is the next location? Left curly brace is the next location. So forward pointer and lexeme begin pointer will be placed at this location. So next forward pointer reads left curly brace. So left curly brace is readed by the forward pointer. Next forward pointer is placed at this blank space. So whenever forward pointer reads this blank space, then it identifies that it is the end of the lexeme. So left curly brace is considered as the token. So then after that the forward pointer ignores this blank space, and lexeme begin pointer as well as forward pointer placed at the next character, that is nothing but right curly brace. So here the point is very very simple. Here in order to read the tokens, two pointers are used. The first pointer is lexeme begin pointer and the second pointer is forward pointer. Lexeme begin pointer always points to the beginning character of the current lexeme, whereas forward pointer reads a character and moves one position to the right in order to read the next character. So whenever it identifies a blank space, whenever it encounters a blank space, encounters means recognizes. So whenever the forward pointer encounters or recognizes a blank space, then it identifies that it is the end of the current lexeme. So what will happen is the previous data will be considered as a token, and the forward pointer ignores this blank space, and both forward pointer as well as lexeme begin pointer will places at the next token, will places at the next character. But the major problem with this approach is we know that whenever we save a program, then the corresponding program is stored in hard disk. Here for reading each character from the secondary memory, for reading each character from the hard disk, then one system call is needed. So for reading I, one system call is needed. For reading N, one system call is needed. For reading T, one system call is needed. For reading blank space, one system call is needed. So if our program size is very very large, then we require a lot of system calls. Let the program size is 1000 characters, then how many system calls are needed? 1000 system calls are needed. So it is unnecessarily burden on the computer as well as the corresponding I/O mechanism. So we can overcome this problem with the help of input buffering techniques. So what is the problem here? We know that the corresponding program is saved in hard disk. So at a time, we can read only one character from the hard disk. So if the program size is very, very larger one, then we require too many system calls in order to read the data from the corresponding hard disk. So we can overcome this problem with the help of buffering techniques. Now let's see what is the use of buffering. Buffering means instead of reading a single character from the hard disk, a block of characters are to be read into the buffer simultaneously with the help of a single system call. So what is a buffer? A block of characters to be read into the buffer using only one system call. But here previously what is happening, in order to read a single character from the hard disk, we require one system call. So if the program size is 1000 characters, then we need 1000 system calls in order to read the corresponding data. Whereas if we use this buffering, what will happen? We can read a block of characters into the buffer with the help of only one system call. So what is the use of buffering? Buffering means we can read a block of data into the buffer at a time using a single system call. Buffering can be implemented in two ways. The first way is one buffer scheme, and the second way is two buffer scheme. Now let's see the first approach. The first approach here is one buffer scheme. One buffer scheme means we use only one buffer to read the input stream. Here let the input string is int space, this is space, I comma j semicolon, int I comma j semicolon. So one buffer scheme means we use only one buffer in order to store the input stream. So here also we use just two pointers. The first pointer is lexeme begin pointer and the second pointer is forward pointer. So lexeme begin pointer always points to the beginning character of the current lexeme, whereas forward pointer points to the, initially points to the first character, and after that every time forward pointer is incremented to read the remaining tokens. But here the problem with this approach is if the input string size is larger than the capacity of the buffer, then we have to overread in the buffer in order to store the remaining input string. Let our input string size is 500 characters, whereas the size of the buffer is 100 characters. So what will happen now is the first 100 characters of the input string are to be read into the buffer. So after processing those 100 characters, the remaining 100 characters, the next 100 characters, that means from 101 to 200, are to be stored in the buffer by overwriting the previous 100 characters. So after processing the characters from 101 to 200, so what we have it? This buffer is overwritten and replaced with the next 100 characters. So 201 to 300. So here the problem is if our input string size is larger than the capacity of the buffer, Then the buffer has to be overwritten in order to store the remaining input string. Here the size of the input string is 500 characters, whereas the size of the buffer is 100 characters. So in the buffer we can store only the first 100 characters. So we have to overwrite in the buffer in order to store the remaining characters of the input string. So we can overcome this problem with the help of a two buffer scheme. So the second one is two buffer scheme. So in a two buffer scheme, we can maintain two buffers. So instead of maintaining a single buffer, here two buffers are maintained. So let it be the first buffer, and it is the second buffer. Let the content of the first buffer is int space I comma j semicolon, and the content of the second buffer is I is equal to I plus 1 semicolon. So this is the content of the first buffer and this is the content of the second buffer. So initially let's see begin pointer and forward pointer points to the beginning character of the first buffer. So let's see begin and forward pointer points to the beginning character of the first buffer. So what is the beginning character of the first buffer? I. Then after that, first the first buffer is filled. So whenever the first buffer is completely filled, then we have to refill the second buffer. So that means after the first buffer is completely filled, then only we have to start the filling of the second buffer. So we have to determine whether the first buffer is completely filled or not. So for that purpose, a special character called EOF. EOF stands for end of the file buffer. The other name for the EOF is sentinel character. The other name for EOF is sentinel character. So in order to determine whether the first buffer is completely filled or not, a special character called EOF or sentinel character is inserted in the last position. That is nothing but after the block of the data, at the last position this will be inserted. And here also this is the second buffer. In order to know whether the second buffer is completely filled or not, a special character called end of the file character or sentinel character is inserted at the last position, that is after the corresponding block of data. Here EOF or sentinel character is a special character which is not the part of the source program. So this character is not the part of the source program. This EOF character is also called as sentinel character. So first what will happen, let's see begin pointer and forward pointer will be placed at the beginning position of the first buffer. So first forward pointer reads the first character, that is nothing but I. Next forward pointer reads N. Next forward pointer reads T. Next forward pointer reads blank space. So whenever forward pointer reads blank space, then it identifies that it is the end of the lexi. So int is considered as a token. So this information will be stored in the symbol table. Then after that, it ignores, the forward pointer ignores this blank space, and both lexi begin and forward pointer will be placed at the next token. So what is the next token? So this is nothing but lexi begin. This is nothing but forward pointer I. So forward pointer reads I. Next to forward pointer is placed at comma. So whenever it reads comma, then it comes to know that it is a token. So I will be stored in the identifier. So likewise the processing will be done. So whenever the forward pointer encounters EOF, so encounters means recognizes. So whenever forward pointer recognizes this EOF, then it identifies that it is the end of the first buffer. That means the first buffer is completely filled. So now the filling of the second buffer will start. So now the forward pointer as well as lexi begin will be placed at the beginning character of the second buffer.
So first forward pointer reads I. So thereafter that both legs in begin and forward pointer will be placed at is equal to. So after likewise the processing will be done. So whenever forward pointer reads this EOF, then it identifies that it is the end of the second buffer. So whenever the second buffer is completely filled, then the remaining input string has to be filled in the first buffer. So now the first buffer data will be overwritten. Now let's see input buffering algorithm. Input buffering algorithm. Switch off. Star here forward is a pointer. So switch off star forward plus plus. So this is post increment operation. Here we are writing a case for end of the file character. So it is a character. So we have to enclose in single quotation. So case EOF. If here the first condition is if forward is H, end of first buffer. If forward is at end of the first buffer, let us assume that here our input string size is 500 characters, whereas the size of each buffer is 100 characters. So now what we have it, the input string size is 500 characters, whereas the buffer 1 size is 100 characters, buffer 2 size is 100 characters. Here what is the condition here? If forward is at the end of the first buffer, that means the first buffer contains the characters from 1 to 100. So the first 100 characters are stored in the first buffer. So whenever the forward pointer is at end of the second buffer, is at end of the first buffer, then it identifies that the first buffer is completely filled. So what we have to do now? We have to fill the second buffer. So we need to place forward pointer at the beginning of the second buffer. So here the statement is forward is equal to beginning of second buffer. So now forward should be placed at the beginning of the second buffer and refill the second buffer. So refill second buffer. So now what will happen now? The first 100 characters are available in first buffer. So the next 100 characters from 101 to 200 are placed in the second buffer. Now let's write the second condition. If forward is H, end of the second buffer. That means the 100 characters are processed here. Now forward pointer is at end of the second buffer. So whenever forward pointer encounters this EOF, then it identifies that it is the end of the second buffer. That means the second buffer is completely filled. So what we have to do now? We have to overwrite the first buffer. So forward pointer should be placed at the beginning of the first buffer. So forward is equal to beginning of first buffer. Then after that we have to refill the first buffer. So refill first buffer. So this is nothing but else if. So if this condition is false, so then only this block will be executed. So now what will happen now? So in the first buffer, the next 200 characters from 201 to 300 are stored. Then after that forward pointer identifies this first buffer EOF character. So whenever it reaches this EOF, then it comes to know that the first buffer is full. So what will happen? The forward pointer should be placed at beginning of the second buffer. So likewise the processing will be done. Else break, because here we are writing the condition for only EOF character. That means if forward pointer is at the end of the first buffer, then forward is placed at beginning of the second buffer and refill the second buffer. Else if forward is at end of the second buffer, then we need to place forward at the beginning of the first buffer and we need to refill the first buffer. If these two conditions are true, then we have to break the lexical analysis process.
there is no need to perform any operation here. Now write the cases for other characters. Here we are showing only EOF character, end of the file character. So cases for other characters. Next, close the switch. So in this way we can implement input buffering technique with the help of one buffer scheme as well as two buffer scheme.